Rachel, and welcome back to a video. Today, I am giving you guys the ultimate guide to shading. I get so many requests for how to shade, how to use Copics, how to color pencils, and everything regarding shading. So this is my ultimate guide on how to shade. So if you don't know what shading is, basically it's placing shadows in your artwork to represent how the light hits your object. So first I wanted to go over the most common lighting techniques. We're gonna use a person as my subject, so I laid out a few examples. So first we're gonna go over the most common threes. Most often, at least when I'm doing art and a lot of other artists, they like to place their light source on up above their character. And this is something to think about when you're creating your artwork, is where is your lighting source coming from? So most of the time it is one lighting source. You can choose where your light is coming from. If you have two lighting sources, make sure to put that into account too. So for these first common three, the first one, I've got it in the top left. And basically what you want to think of is, where is the light not going to hit on your character? So in this example, it's going to create a shadow under his neck and a lot on the right side of his body because it's coming from the upper left. So since his head creates an overhang over his chest, that means the light is not going to hit right under his neck, thus creating a shadow. My next example is from the top right. This is the same thing, it's just gonna be on the left side now, so it's gonna be the bottom parts and left sides of most of his body. And then my third example is from straight above. This is gonna cause pretty much no shadows on the face. Unless there was hair, you might get a shadow under the hair, but it's gonna create a bigger shadow right around the neck area and a lot on his inner arm. Certain places that tend to have more shadows than others is going to be the inner arms, the inner legs, and the neck, because those places are naturally more sunk into the character and thus are gonna be harder to hit with light. Next, I thought I would just give you guys a few examples of more unique lighting sets. These are a little bit less common. So the first one is from the bottom to the left. And this is kind of the opposite of what you saw in the beginning. It's gonna be on the top parts of him, on the right. So his neck is actually going to be lit up now that it's coming from the bottom. It's gonna hit right into his neck, so you're not gonna have any shadows there, but you'll start to get it on the top parts of his arms and the top of his head. My second example is if the light was facing straight towards him, you're gonna get pretty much no shadows at all because the light is going straight at him from a hip level and it's gonna cover up pretty much everything. You might get a little bit of shadows right in the armpit area. And then if the light was coming from straight behind them, you'd have shadows on pretty much the entire character except for the very outline of the character, because the light would leak onto the outline of the character, thus creating a highlight. Okay, so those are some of the most basic lighting methods. This is going to be kind of the template of your shadows and where you need to place your shadows. So whenever you're starting an art piece, make sure to always take into account where your lighting source is coming from so you know where to put your shadows. So now we're gonna go over a few shading techniques, starting with black and white. First off, I'm using the simple like ball circle representation just because it's easiest. You've seen this in probably a lot of other videos. There's a bunch of different methods to do shading. I'm just going over the most common three and the most that I use. The first method is the smooth / natural look. And basically it is putting your, I guess, brush strokes or your pencil strokes in the most natural form of the object. So if it's a circle, it's gonna be kind of curvy with the object's natural flow. If it was hair, it's gonna go along the hair. Clothes, it depends on, I guess, the threading of it. The whole point of the smooth / natural look is to make it all flow into one and look completely smooth and natural. Like, you can't really see where the lines are. A lot of people will also take like a smoothing tool to kind of rub out the whole pencil work, or just use their thumb. That works completely fine, and that's one way to shadow. The next one is called the hatch. This is the one that I probably use the most often, and it's putting lines in a consecutive order parallel to each other. They don't overlap at all. The closer they are and the more of them there are, the darker the area is, and as you put them farther apart or put less of them, the lighter the area is. And then our last example is crosshatch, which is also a really helpful technique. Basically, it's a lot like hatch, but when you want to put darker areas, you can put lines perpendicular or at an angle to the parallel ones, and those make it really dark and can help darken your shadows. Now, a few things regarding pencils or black and white work. You can get gradient pencils that have different, I guess, depth or darkness to them. So I have a set of these from Faber-Castell. I don't think these are necessary at all. It's just a thing that if you're really into pencil work, you can go ahead and get if you want to. But here's a quick example, HB, B, 2B, 4B, 6B, and 8B. As you get higher in the numbers, they get darker in color. But I also wanted to show you guys that you can accomplish this pretty much exactly with a number 2 pencil. All you have to do is the harder that you push with the pencil, the darker the color is going to get. And as you want to get into the really light colors, just let go of the pressure and it'll lighten up for you. Now I thought I would show you guys a little bit on how to shade with colored pencils. We're going to be going over colored pencils and markers because those are my most prominent mediums that I can teach you guys the most about. But first off, for a single color, or if you're trying to fade into white or something like that, the harder you push with the colored pencil, the darker color you're going to get. Also, it'll be the most vibrant, and the lighter you push on it, the lighter the color is going to get, a lot like just a regular number 2 pencil. So that's how you can fade into white or make the color fade lighter. Now for dual color, this is probably the most common way that I do shading. Let's say I have a character that has a red shirt and now I want to go ahead and shade it. So I will set down a base color of red across the entire shirt and then I will take brown and put in my shadows. So if the lighting source was coming from the top left, I would place it on the right side and like under his neck and places that there will be shadows, and then I go back with my red colored pencil and I go back over where I put the brown and kind of fade it back into the red, and it'll make it nice and smooth. Then for opposite colors, basically it just takes a lot of blending, so putting the two colors next to each other and then overlapping them in the middle and then slowly blending them out on each side. Now we're gonna get into markers. So for techniques regarding markers, it's a lot like colored pencils, and it's a little bit harder to get in the black and white techniques like hatching and stuff like that because it's markers at all, just kind of blend in together. You can do that with colored pencils, but not really as much with markers. So you're kind of going for more of a smooth look most of the time. If you want to shade it with one color, this usually happens if you don't have a darker color of your base coat, or if you're just looking for a really subtle shadow. First, you want to place your base color and then let it dry, and then you can go back over with that same marker and it'll appear darker. It won't be nearly as effective as if you were to place a different color, but it still works. Now for dual color, what you want to do is put in your base coat and then put your darker color over your base coat and then go back with your base coat and just blend it. So you're gonna just go right over where your darker color and your lighter color is and just kind of go right over it, and it'll slowly blend out. Now for a triple shadow blend, this is if you want to get like those really deep colors, you're gonna go over the entire thing with your base coat, then your second coat, and then your third coat, depending on how big your shadow is. And then once you've got all those coats done, you can go with your second color and blend out that darkest color, and then to your light color and blend out the second one. For opposite colors, it's a lot like colored pencils. It's placing those two colors next to each other and then blending them in the middle to make one color. You can also take, like, let's say I did a red and a blue, you could take a purple marker and put that in the middle, which will help emphasize the purple in the middle. And then if you're fading into white, this one is a little bit more difficult, especially if you don't have a super light gray or any of like the light colors, but you're gonna need a colorless blender, which you can get with almost any marker brand. So you put in your base coat, usually want to go with a lighter color, and then take your colorless blender and blend that out. Alright guys, well this was my ultimate guide to shading. I really hope it helped you guys out. I wanted to cover as much as I could regarding shading and colors and all the things art related. So if this helped you at all, go ahead and leave a like. Leave a comment down below, let me know what you guys want to see next on my channel. And don't forget to subscribe for more awesome art videos, and I'll see you guys next time. Bye!